Hi, I'm Erin East, and welcome to Scopes University. In this episode, I'm going to be talking about how to save time in your setup by using some of the intuitive controls and touchscreen capabilities built into your oscilloscope. So I'll be talking about five different tips that you can use to save time in your setup. So this will allow you to spend less time on setting up your measurements and more time on the actual analysis that you care about. I'll be talking about some quick scaling tips, how to use the built-in voice control capability, some of the shortcuts that you can find for using the touchscreen, how to customize your sidebar, and how to utilize the built-in help capability. So let's go ahead and get started with the quick scaling tips. So there's a few different ways that I can scale my waveform on the scope. I can use the knobs found on the front panel, or I can use the touchscreen. So let's take a look at my scope. We see there's a very nice large touchscreen display, and we're still able to have dedicated vertical control knobs for each of the four channels on the oscilloscope. So this makes it a lot easier to control each of those channels vertically. The first way I can control my scaling is by using the vertical control knobs. And if I press that vertical control knob in, we'll see it activates fine mode, and I can adjust that at a more fine level. And we can use the smaller knob to adjust the vertical positioning so we can apply an offset to the signal. And if I turn that knob and accidentally set too much of an offset, I can just press in that vertical positioning knob and it will bring it back to 0 volts at the center of the screen. The same goes for the horizontal positioning knob. I can press that in for fine mode to be activated. And I can use that horizontal positioning knob to change the delay that I see on screen and press it in to set the delay back to 0 seconds. The fastest way to adjust my scaling is by using the multi-touch capability. So this means I can actually pinch to zoom in and out of my waveform and make that scale larger or smaller. I can also move it around on screen to apply an offset as well. So this is just a really quick way to be able to center what you want to see on screen. Now let's talk about the voice control capability. So this really comes in handy when your hands are full from probing. So if you're using both of your hands to probe on your device, then you really can't use your hands to make any adjustments to what you're seeing on your scope screen. So if I say, "Hello, scope," we can see that microphone up in the top right corner lights up, and now it's listening to what we're saying. So I can say something like, "Move left, move right, bigger, smaller, zoom in, zoom out, auto scale, turn on channel 2. Another thing that will help you save a lot of time in your setup are the shortcuts that you can find through the touchscreen. So the whole scope was optimized to use with a touchscreen, so that means it's really easy to use all of the touch capabilities. And because it has a nice large display, all of the buttons are really large and easy to press. So you can actually access all of the capabilities of the scope through the touchscreen alone. So if you go into this main menu up in the top left corner here, you can access all of the capabilities of the scope through this main menu. And you can see there's also a couple shortcuts along the side here that can help make your measurements a lot quicker as well. And if you ever get lost in any of the menus, say we go into the measurement menu, you go in to change some settings and change the threshold values, and now you want to get back out into that main measurement menu, all you have to do is use this dedicated back button to go to the previous menu that you were in. Also, there are two different touchscreen modes. So the mode that we're currently in is that multi-touch waveform scroll mode. So that's what allows me to zoom in and out on my waveform and scroll it around on screen. We also have the zone mode. So if I look in the top right corner of my touchscreen here, I see there's a sine wave highlighted. If I touch that, I'll see the box is now highlighted. We're now in zone mode. So what that means is we can draw boxes on the screen, and those can be used to add annotations. They can also be used for zone triggering, but I'll talk about that in a later episode. And the next thing I'll talk about is how to customize your sidebar. So you can actually change around what you're seeing on your sidebar so that you see all of the information that you need to at one time. So we can see I have that populated now with a couple measurements, but let's say I want to look at that frequency measurement, that peak-to-peak measurement, and also be utilizing my DVM and view that on my screen at the same time. So I can do that with the different docking options I have in that side screen. So if I just hold that measurement window, I can see my docking options open up here. If I drag that into the bottom option there, now we see the measurements only populate the bottom half of that sidebar. And now I can put something else in the top half here. So I can touch the sidebar menu button, that blue button there, and select any of these options. So let's take a look at my DVM. Now I can view my DVM and my measurements at the same time. Now, if I wanted to view even more information at the same time, I can actually drag these windows in the sidebar out to the center of my scope screen. So if I just grab my DVM, I can drag that right out there. So now I can see my DVM window, my measurements window, and my summary window all at the same time. And there's several other options of what you can add to that sidebar. So it's really helpful to be able to view these multiple capabilities at one time as you're making those measurements. And for the windows that you drag out to the center of your scope screen, you can actually change those to be transparent. So if I select this blue button and select transparent dialogues, then I'll see that window becomes transparent there, and now I can see my waveform through that DVM window. And when you're looking at things like the DVM or different measurements, it's really easy to change the sources of what that's actually looking at. So right now I have the DVM looking at channel 1, but if I just touch on the DVM, I can see it can change the digital voltmeter mode and the source. So I can change that source to any of my channels. So it's really quick and easy to be able to change between the different channels that you want to look at. The last thing I want to talk about is how to utilize the built-in help capability. So this is going to save you a lot of time because you won't have to go online and search through a data sheet to figure out what certain features can be used for. You can actually figure this all out right within the scope itself. If you're ever confused about any of the menu options associated with these soft keys or any of the front panel options, all you have to do is hold down the button associated with that and it will pop up some built-in help describing what that option is and what it can be used for, and sometimes give you a quick setup tip as well. So those 5 tips I just talked about are going to be really helpful in saving you time in your setup, so you'll spend less time setting up your measurement and more time on the actual analysis. Having that large display is really helpful in being able to see a lot of signal detail, and having those dedicated vertical control knobs for each channel make it really easy for us to change our scaling on the fly. Thanks for watching, and I hope you use these tips in your everyday measurements. Make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel to see more videos like this, and like us on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter so that you can stay updated on our events. To learn more about your scope, make sure you download the ebook, 6 Essential Tips to Getting the Most Out of Your Oscilloscope.